Γεια σας φίλοι μου, today we are talking about the small words όπως and σαν that both mean like or as, but in Greek we use them in different ways. Let's get started! So, let's talk about σαν first. As you can see here, we use it before a noun in accusative with the article. For example, η Σοφία είναι δασκάλα σαν τη Μαρία. The noun τη Μαρία is an accusative with the article. Another example. Το στυλό είναι άσπρο σαν τον πίνακα. The noun τον πίνακα is a masculine noun and it's an accusative because it's after the word σαν. Now, if we want to use the word σαν with a personal pronoun, to say, for example, like me, we need always the accusative of the strong type of personal pronouns. When I say strong type, I mean the words εμένα, εσένα, αυτόν, αυτήν, αυτό, εμάς, εσάς, αυτούς, αυτές, αυτά. Like the examples, σαν εμένα, σαν εσένα, σαν αυτόν, σαν αυτήν, σαν αυτό, σαν εμάς, σαν εσάς, σαν αυτούς, σαν αυτές, σαν αυτά. And some more examples in the sentences below. Μαγειρεύεις πολύ καλά, σαν εμένα. Δεν είμαι καλός στα μαθηματικά σαν εσένα. Σαν εμάς κι εσύ δεν βλέπεις ταινίες. Δεν θέλω να είμαι σαν αυτόν. Sometimes σαν can be used with nominative. This happens only in similar sentences and without the article. For example, πεινάω σαν λύκος. This noun λύκος is in nominative. Also, we use σαν before a verb plus να, I mean with subjunctive. Example. Τρώμε σαν να μην υπάρχει αύριο. This is a common expression in Greek and it means that we eat a lot without thinking about that. This μην means not, only for subjunctive and imperative, because you know that we have another common not, the word then. Σαν να μη πέρασε μια μέρα. Again a common phrase, and it means like, as if one day hasn't passed. Another example now. Σαν να βρέχει λίγο. Now this sentence means, I think that it's raining. Or σαν να πεινάω λίγο. And this means again, I think that I'm little hungry. If you have any question, please write it down to the comments. And now let's go to όπως. Όπως means again like, as, but now the syntax is different. We can use it with all the cases, nominative, accusative and genitive, always with an article before the noun. Let's see an example with the nominative. Η Μαρία είναι δασκάλα όπως η μητέρα της. The word μητέρα is feminine, so we need η as an article. Ο Γιώργος δουλεύει πολύ όπως ο πατέρας του. The same here, but now the word πατέρας is masculine. And now let's see how to use όπως with accusative. Watch out that it can be used like σαν. The syntax is different, I mean. You can understand better with an example. Αγαπάω τη Σοφία όπως την κόρη μου. And the question here is why accusative? Because in the sentence αγαπάω τη Σοφία, the word Σοφία is the object to the verb αγαπάω. As you know from another video I made, you'll find it up here, the object in Greek is usually in accusative, as the word τη Σοφία. And in the other sentence, I mean after the comma in the part όπως την κόρη μου, the verb αγαπάω is implied again. You can understand that from the translation. So the word την κόρη will be the object again. That's why it's an accusative here. Another example. Βοηθάω τον παππού μου όπως τον πατέρα μου. Here again, both τον παππού and τον πατέρα are objects to the verb βοηθάω. Please leave your questions down to the comments in order to know that you understand what I'm saying. And now we are going in genitive, that it's not so common like nominative and accusative. An example. Η τσάντα της Σοφίας είναι μπλε, όπως της Μαρίας. You know maybe that the genitive case is used to declare the possession, like in the example. Η τσάντα της Σοφίας means Sophia's bag. In the second sentence, I mean in the part όπως της Μαρίας, the word τσάντα is implied again, as you can see from the translation. So that's why here, after όπως, we used the genitive. And now, if we want to use the word όπως with a personal pronoun, we use it always with the nominative case of personal pronouns. The nominative of personal pronouns, it is εγώ, εσύ, αυτός, αυτή, αυτό, εμείς, εσείς, αυτοί, αυτές, αυτά. Let's go to an example. Η Μαρία είναι δασκάλα όπως εγώ. After όπως, we used the nominative of personal pronoun. Ο Γιώργος είναι καλός άνθρωπος όπως εσύ. Also, we can use όπως with a verb, like σαν, but with a different syntax. As I told you before, with σαν we use να, but with όπως not. For example, όπως ξέρεις δουλεύω αύριο. So here we have όπως plus present. And another example, όπως θέλετε κύριε Κώστα. And in the next examples we have όπως plus past. Όπως έτρεχα έπεσα. Όπως μαγείρευα, άκουσα το τηλέφωνο. Also, we can use the words σαν and όπως with adverbs. For example, we always say όπως πάντα and not σαν πάντα. It's not correct in Greek. And also we say όπως εδώ and not σαν εδώ. But we can say both σαν τώρα, όπως τώρα. Σαν χτες, όπως χτες. Σαν σήμερα, όπως σήμερα. But we use them in different ways. Let's see some examples. Το θυμάμαι σαν τώρα. Φάγαμε μακαρόνια σήμερα, όπως χθες. Σαν σήμερα γεννήθηκα. Θα πάμε στη Σαντορίνη το καλοκαίρι, όπως πέρυσι. So this was the lesson. If you liked it, thumbs it up, and for more lessons, subscribe to this channel. I'm going to upload some exercises with όπως and σαν on Facebook and Instagram, so follow me there if you need some practice. It would be my pleasure to answer to your questions. I hope you have a beautiful day. Τα λέμε στο επόμενο μάθημα. Γεια σας!